And we're good. Hello and welcome to Daytona 300 Forza Motorsports 6. Gonna do the Daytona 300 endurance run. It's not the basic oval, it's a sports car circuit. It's gonna be 84 laps, 300 miles. We're looking at probably about 2 hours. So, get ready to have fun. Let's make sure everything is golden here. Public preview, okay, that's good. Turn that off. Let's see here. Just want to make sure everything's going good. Go. Let's type that into a browser. Okay. Okay. Let's roll.
Your next race will be at Daytona International Speedway, featuring high-banked corners that assist top speed.
Okay. 11.
The prestigious Daytona International Speedway features high-banked corners for maximum downforce at top speed, testing the limits of both car and driver.
Best car and the driver. So, we're going to use the Pagot this time around instead of the Audi. Just get the spread out my affinity. So, shit, that's the wrong one. Holy shit, that's a lot of money. 330,000. Guaranteed you get a million for this. So, right now we're gonna be using two boosts. We're gonna be using the credit boost. We're also gonna use the experience boost. And then for our blue boost, we're gonna be using the powertrain engineer for that extra 10% to power. That's going to allow me, because all these cars are exactly the same, it's going to allow me to kick it up a notch. There we go. Cool. Let's see here. Oh. There's no full screen mode in this? Is that F10? No. It's F11. Okay. Then, I'm not going to use any dares, because it's not going to be sufficient amount of credit. And, yeah, good to go. Assists, we're going to be consisting of brake line, ABS, steering is normal, traction control, let's turn that all on, automatic shifting, simulation on, and rewind on. So in the first, it's not the oval. If this was the oval, I would definitely turn a lot of that stuff off, because I would just, like, I'd probably get my rubber band. Probably get a rubber band to do laps and all that stuff. Driver difficulty, I'm going to be using a highly skilled. And let's look at the starting grid. So we're going to be racing, five of us are going to be racing in a pack with the other 19 will be racing in their lower tier. So it could get a little iffy around the corners and all that stuff. So, let's get started. Actually, let me get some water.
Right.
think we're good. I think we're good. Get the controller here. Shit, my water's way over there. Okay. Whew. Go. At lunch. So I'm all full, or I'll have tons of calories to burn. Getting ready for a seat. And let's do this. Right, wrong button. So I was thinking earlier today, I was doing some, I needed to drop off something at Best Buy, that I might pick up the pre-installed Gran Turismo 5 from PS3 and maybe do some endurance running there. I really enjoy endurance runs. I think it's... Whoa. A little bit too tight. There we go, let's turn it in here. Boogie. So my pit strategy is going to be, of course, pit after they do. Once they start getting really far back and they left the screen, there is the distance in feet. I wish it was time. Usually pits take about 30 seconds. Ah, oh, God, that's weird. Ugh. Wow, that's a far rewind. Oh god, that's not looking good. Now, last race, I was doing the Le Mans 150, I think. Le Mans. Check my channel, I got that posted up. About halfway through, I did get in a car accident, and I lost my front, my headlights. So, it was really bad. It was really scary. Oh my god, I'm not getting any... So that was a little scary the first few times, and then I cranked up the brightness, black light, and contrast on my TV, and I barely made it. I have since reset those settings on my TV, and we shouldn't be having a problem with headlights now, since this track is fairly good. need to fucking, I need to clean up that corner. It's too low to see where the line is. Since race cars have such great grip and braking and acceleration, it's really hard to figure out where I should brake compared to a standard, like, you know, a Ferrari or even a, like a Toyota or a Honda non-racing class car. This time around, they do have a lot of more racing version cars, which is I really like. So modified Ferraris, Lamborghinis, Lexus, Hondas, all sorts of stuff that are more geared towards, you know, touring. It would be cool if there was a ghost of the fastest laps. That would be really cool. I don't know how much they could add to that. Adding like an extra ghost. I would really like that in racing games. Just pulling data of the little bit faster laps you can beat, see what's going on, see what they're doing. Mind of perfection. Like to state that I won't be able to answer any comments, and I'm 100% focused on this. But if you do post a comment in the archive of this, I will do reply. I'll reply to all comments that deserve a comment. Reply. The best is what I gotta do is lightly tap, just tilt the thing. The controller's a little bit sensitive. Like, sometimes I don't even need the brake. Good coast is good. Again, a mile is about, like, let's keep, like, 5,200 feet. So when they start getting back a mile, I can start pitting, be a little bit more less cautious. God damn, this camera's really fucked up. Maybe I should switch to a, no. I need a stable thing. Give me... Oh, and then I have felt it. Third person is okay, but I just have a hard time figuring out where my car is going. Relative to my tires. I can see where my car is going, but I don't, like, know how far it's going, because the camera kind of has a little bit of swivel. And of course, this is, like, no field of view. This is a little bit disorienting. It's not that bad, actually. It's just, like, you're going so fast. First pack of cars down here. Now, this step class could help, depending on if they stay together. If they stay together, it will help me gain farther. I feel like the AI tends to clump up. And so when they clump up, it's harder. It's harder for, like, the AI itself on all, like, the class I'm... Oh, Jesus. Ah, fuck. I'm racing will get clumped into their AI or something, and I feel like it, they might have a hard time God damn it. Having my heart passing. Oh, that was a slow lap because of the extra traffic. Damn it! Can't be fucking up this early. What are the laps? Shit, I should be focusing on the laps than factoring how long I'm actually going to be here. Little Mollins was a little under 2 hours. I predicted it would be 2:10. It's very interesting that this is not the the oval track. It's the sports circuit. I think later on today I will... with the Indy, which is the oval, and that's in Indy cars. That should be fine. It would be interesting to, if the endurance races were like, hey, pick any car you want, and then we'll do the, God, I'm taking that too slow. The math and figure out which cars are similar to that car and in that class. So if I want to race a fucking Hummer, fucking 80 laps of, was that a minute 42? Shit! Minute 48. 84. That's... God damn it. Like... I can't see the fucking road. I'm gonna have to go up there for something. The AI is just so weird. Like, look at the, look how close 3rd, 4th, and 5th are. It's very weird. Closing the book on this game and the career. Now I'm at the pro. God damn it. The pro level of racing. So I have access to Indy cars, Formula cars, prototypes, racing cars in general, which should be pretty fun. So since I'm so far ahead, I'm pretty sure I can hit at any time and still be in first. But we're gonna just keep on pushing that number. Again, the fuel is right below my gear number. The sticks right now are really sensitive. I'm barely fucking touching this thing. Dude, let me get a clean lap up too. So far these are pretty dirty. There is no tuning in this in the showcases. It would be cool if you could make your own endurance runs. I wouldn't mind doing 300 laps in the freaking in the formula on Daytona. There's no Monaco. That would be pretty cool. That it was Monaco. They actually reference Monaco, but it's not in it. It's hilarious. There's a few tracks I would have liked. The Suzuka, I would have liked that one. That was the Red Red novel. There's no Japanese courses in this. I wonder if this has to do with Gran Turismo. But they were in Forza 4. And that's another one I'm going to look into doing endurance runs in Forza 4. I think they hit it. No, I'm not really far back. Son of a bitch. And going outside that line, that's gonna cause a bad third lap. God damn it, having these cars here is going to cause a 30 lap too. God, I need some fucking decrease the sensitivity. It's so fucking loose right now. I'm barely fucking touching it. It's the car. This is going to be a lot of pitting here. I'm on lap 12, and I feel like I'm going to need a pit real soon. I'm down to a one-third tank left, maybe a quarter. No, I should be safe. I don't want to pit too often. Let's pin on lap, at the end of lap 14. So two more laps. Yeah, let's do that. It'll be every 14 laps I should be able to do. That will be 8 pits overall. Yeah? No. God damn it. 7 pits. No, 6B. Now it'll be 7. But yeah, let's do 14. That seems safe. Now when you do run out of fuel, you're dead. You're dead, dude. It's not like you get a little bit of gas. You're no fuel. No, nothing. Until you hit the pit, then it just revs it up and then you fill up on stuff. So I definitely gonna do that. Not run out of fuel. 14 flaps seems good. Also, Bathurst, I get a strategy for that. I have a car mod, Spectre mod, that makes you invisible, makes everybody, all the cars invisible. And I think I might apply that. I hate to feel like that track is too tight for so many cars. And it's just so really hard to pass. And there's only a few places to pass because the road is so narrow. There's places to pass for straightaways, and it's really hard to pass on a straightaway. Probably do a 15th, but I might run out of fuel. Ooh, that's somebody. Probably 5th. It is 5th. 6th? Wait, 4th? Wait, what? I'm really gonna lap 5th and 4th? Wow, maybe I should change the difficulty. Holy shit. Oh god, I need a pin. Take one quick break here. Pause it. I thought I needed to use the restroom, but I don't. Interesting. So the next one would be on 28? At least I know that at 18,000 feet, this one I lapped. So from there, I know that about a fourth of a lap away, it's probably like 20 seconds behind. Slow. There goes a fucking clean lap. Coming up on fourth real soon. Gets him up there. Ah. Oh my god. This is the scary part. When the replays, rewinds don't work. That fourth. That has to be fourth. I've already passed fifth. Jesus Christ, for the last fucking second. Yeah, this is so fucking weird. That second right there? Oh my god. Wait, what is that? Or is that third? What the fuck? This will be my... Oh, this is the... This is third. So it's about 19,000 feet. Nice round number. 19,000 feet is one lap, okay. I swear to God, I thought I already passed four. Now that would be my fourth one I passed. There's only five. Yeah, the AI don't cut these corners. You can, they're clean laps. Rumble strips, you can do that. You can go on rumble strips. So the next pit will be on after about 28. Oh shit, that's not a good time. God, these batteries are great too. I'm using inner loops, the black for blacks, which have a shit ton of battery life. I've been playing this in 4th of 5 for the past month, and I haven't been able to. I didn't need to change my batteries. The rechargeable lasts forever. Makes the Xbox 360 controller and Xbox One controller just that much better than all the other controllers. Just due to you being able to use off-the-shelf batteries. Fucking 4,000 milliamp battery. 4,000 milliamp battery. My phone has a smaller battery. And it's 800 on fucking the, on the DualShock 4. 800 milliamps! You know how small that is? I mean, it's powering two motors, a light, and then a sensor, touchpads, all that stuff. It's just like, why? Why is it so small? Oh, fuck you! Fuck you. Fuck. No. Get some grip. Ooh, second place is right up ahead. I have newfound respect for fucking drivers, racers. Even the fucking stock car shit, that shit is not easy. It's not comfortable. Like, these cars don't have AC. You're fucking... It's not easy. Where's second? Oh, second's right up there. Wait, where's second? Oh, there he is. Let's see if we can get a clean flat this time around. Oh no, shit, there's traffic up ahead. The person that made a comment, I cannot read it, and that screen's like 5 minutes, 5 feet away, but I will get to it next time I pit. 100% focus on this shit. We're not doing that. Oh my god! The vibration in my fucking controller just turned off. That is fucking smart. That is really smart. So that means I'm gonna have to pause this right now and get a new pair of batteries. There we go. Stream with Lancey. Not really good friends with him. Be right back. I mean, I've done his videos, but I'm not. I don't do much. I'm back with some batteries. Actually, so these are these Panasonic Antelopes Pros. I'm looking on here. They're lithium here. 1.2 volts, 2,450 milliamp hours. That's a lot. That is a lot of fucking juice. For just having to be in a triple A, for a double A. And, Jesus Christ, that's a lot of power. But yeah, I've done some videos with Lance, but he's never asked me. It's usually a friend, asks me to, join with him. Okay. Jesus Christ, my laps are so much faster than the previous. Okay. Let's roll. Yeah, we're rolling back. So what you want to do is, since batteries are forms of electricity, they're storages of electricity, there's different types of batteries. Fuck you. Batteries is the concept of storing energy. So energy could be anything. Technically, fat is our batteries. They are energy in the most purest form in what a creature could use. So calories, we eat calories. A hamburger has some calories, vegetables have calories, all have calories. And from there, our mouth crunches them down, and then our saliva breaks it down farther, and then once it hits into our stomach, it dissolves into pretty much liquid goop. From there, it is stored into our body, or burned right away. So that keeps us going. We're warm-blooded creatures. What that means is we have constant temperature, unlike most reptiles. And fish are cold-blooded, so to get their heat, they go to the sun if they want to survive, or they don't need it. So their calorie intake doesn't have to be that much. Same with turtles. Turtles like to eat every other year. Anyways, batteries. I mean, technically, there's projects trying to convert caves into batteries. So you fill it full of air, and then from there you can turn that air into a turbine and all that stuff. Anyways, electric batteries. They work off electrons. So electrons are bouncing all over the battery, and that generates heat, which in turn generates energy. It is a little bit better to throw them into a freezer than to have them out. Because what that does, it slows down the atoms and all that stuff. Oh, and allows it to last a little bit longer, so there's not much of a drain. But yeah, it's just, I am really impressed. Oh, goddammit. By the Xbox One. I'm not a fanboy or anything. I think the PS4, what it does right now, I think it's really great. But what Sony has done is really not done anything interesting. You know, their lineup is not that great. What they've built is just a more advanced PS3. It doesn't have as much bells and whistles. You know, the Xbox One iterated on the Xbox 360, and you know, that whole, it's a medium box, while the PS4 isn't. Like, it's still like a crummy system. Like, it's hard to navigate. You know, it's all, like, it still features that XMB, where it's, you know, it's very, very little data is being presented to you, so it had, like, one bar for your game, so it's really hard to navigate your games. The Xbox One does a really nice job of a grid setup, and I really like that. It allows you to go up and down in a grid, so you're going to have, like, in the main dashboard, you have your games or your apps you pin up to the top, and that's like the 3x, you know, whatever grid of games and apps that you have installed or on your console that you can click. You can navigate. It's super easy. But on the PS4, they don't have that. But then you can go to the library, which is all the way up to the right, which is, again, really hard to navigate because it also throws in games that are not downloaded to the system. So if you sort by, you can sort by alphabetical or I think another stuff, but it's just like, ugh. Super, super cumbersome. Still chasing that fucking dream of a 135 lap. I think it's because the cars are so far apart, I'm gonna run into traffic. So I'm not gonna be able to get any clean laps, definitely, and laps are gonna be a lot slower because I have to deal with traffic. Okay, cool. We're on lap 26. We're gonna do the. We're still on the lap 28 lap. Every 14 laps is a pit. Again, I do have traction control and stability management on. I don't want to deal with that shit. In a car, I really don't. I'm not very fond of. These high-end racing cars, they're rear-wheel drive, so I haven't learned how to handle rear-wheel drive on this game. I can handle all-wheel drive. With all-wheel drive, I can practically, like, fucking coast that shit down. So I have a Lamborghini that I've raced most of the time, so this is such a sweet vehicle. I used the Lamborghini in the Road Atlanta endurance run, and I just got such a great ride. And so I'm lap 28, so one more time around, two more times around the lap. Oh wow, I guess I passed the, no, past fifth, fourth is coming up. damn it.
What else can we talk about?
The Daily Show is coming out real soon. I don't know. I probably won't watch that. I've got an itch. Oh, God. Real bad itch. Okay, next lap, I will be pitting. It should be perfect timing. Might have produced a little bit too much fuel last time around. For this time around, yeah, this is a lot of... Yeah, the Bathurst is going to be probably one of the harder ones, and that's why I use the Spectre mod, which turns everybody invisible or turns off collision, and that will help a lot with trying to pass and just maintaining focus. I really hate that track. Like, it's such a shitty track. It's like the Le Mans, I think it's Road of America. It's just super fucking tight, though. That's very few places in the past. It's like two, and most of the track is fucking like two car widths apart. So it's really fucking hard to pass because, you know, you're in the middle of the road because you want to get the fast, and so you're weaving in and out. We'll see how that goes. Depending on how long this takes, it's probably gonna take more than 2 hours. Oh, fuck, 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 fuck! Oh, shit. Now, if I did not be able to rewind, I could be able to, pit. And I should be golden. But if I did pit, I would have a giant crack. The pitting doesn't fix cosmetics. God, there's a lot of people out there. Oh, this is fifth place. No, that's second place. Yeah. I think the fact that fucking fifth place has been lapped by second place is a little bit jarring. So, next pit would be at, it's 14 plus 28, 32? No, 42. And that would be the halfway mark. Oh wait, no, fucking fourth is not up ahead. That would be fucking 40,000 feet, not 30,000.
would be 38. It would be around 38. You know, I'm actually having more fun doing the endurance races than actually playing the races. Some of these are, this is actually enjoyable, just like going around a corner over and over again. Like, some of the races I'm not having fun. I just wrapped up the Southern Professional Racing in a Honda, and it was so bad. It was just so boring. And I actually got a video of a bug I found in the Honda. Check my channel for that. Another itchy nose. God, like, how would you fucking do this shit, dude? I'm sitting on my nice couch with a fan blowing real nice. You know, it's a nice day here. And it's just... There's no AC, there's no music. You just hear the fucking pit crew just fucking arguing. And they're like, hey, fuck you! Getting fatigued, oh shit. It's coming up on 1 hour here. Come on, come on. Yeah, Rick and Morty. Watch that. That show is fucking great. Like, it's... I'm really impressed by that show. Like, it's... I mean, it's an Adult Swim show, which is... I'm not surprised. Their shit's pretty good. Always been pretty good. Very, like... off the shelf. They're kind of, like, off-ball a little bit. Some of their shit's, like... It's... Who is this? Who is this? Who is this? But who is this? Oh, is this Fifth? Yeah, this is Fifth. Let me pass you, you son of a bitch! That has to be Fifth, yeah? And it's... Fuck you. I'm not in the mood for that. Rick and Morty is just so great. It's... Reminds me a lot about Futurama. Very, like, in that sense of, you know, it's very smart. Smart show for smart people. It has a really good cast, characters, new shenanigans happen every episode that is really cool. Their latest episode was, like, last season they did an episode where they all just watched TV, and it was the fucking funniest thing ever. It was literally, like, it had to be Justin Roiland, who's the character, who does the VO for Rick and Morty, just fucking improvising, and then they animated, because it was fucking hilarious. It was like, I don't know how you write this shit. Like, it was so improv. definitely. It, like, I have Hulu, and I've watched the first season, like, twice now. I rewatch it again. So it's up on there. Latest season is on Adult Swim. If you have cable subscription, you can check that stuff online. Also, I think about just buying Blu-ray. That shit is so funny. But the problem is I don't want to have it on two discs. Anyways, last episode they redid a thing of we watched interdimensional TV. It had me thinking the ending was a little bit wasn't that great. I thought they could have done a little bit better. I won't spoil it, but the my thing is at the end, if it pulled out to be that they were watching the show all along, that would be fucking hilarious. It'd be great. The episode where Rick and Morty go into Rick's microverse that powers his car, that's hilarious. While what's her name? The sister. It's in the spaceship and all that stuff. It's fucking hilarious. The spaceship brokers a deal with, like, because they went to another dimension where you could see Boners 2 or something, a stupid movie, and it was great. So they wanted to get ice cream, but they ran out of, didn't have any power, and so they went into that. I don't know. It was fucking hilarious. I don't know. I like rewatching that show. Cable's really weird because unlike network TV, like, you know, Fox, CBS, NBC, they all have shows that are, you know, 24 episodes. It's usually like 20 to 24 episodes in a season. That's a lot of shows. But on cable, it's usually like 10 episodes, and so you don't run that shit into the ground like they do on network TV. Like, 24 episodes of, like, of The Simpsons, it just, like, kind of wears down. Some of the older stuff of The Simpsons was pretty good, but it's being, like, fucking... It's not funny anymore. The FX app on Xbox One, or the FX app, wherever you are, there's one on Xbox One. You could just watch all the fucking Simpsons. All the Simpsons. And some of the older stuff is fucking hilarious. I go back and forth on the movie. I don't know. Movies of TV shows are horrible because they are just, only thing they are just longer episodes. Longer episodes with shorter seasons, usually, like, serialized TV is a, more, like, you know, Firefly and all that stuff. There's a story arc. There's a story arc going through the whole show, but each episode has a, like, little, its own subplots and all that stuff. But then when you make that into a movie, they don't really fill out much. You're expecting a little bit more. It's just a big episode and all that stuff. And usually it's a little bit too fast. Like a Harry Potter show would be really cool. Or a... Portuguese. I don't know. Some shows would be better as movies. Some shows would be... Movies would be better as a show, I feel like. I feel like the Avengers movies are good movies, and it would be hard to do as a show. I'm not a fan of the S.H.I.E.L.D. or the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I guess Agent Carter is supposed to be good. I don't know. They're making another spinoff. It's got really fucking stupid towards the end of the last season of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. It's got really fucking stupid. It's just part of the mega canon of the film canon. It can get a little bit weird. I don't know, going back and thinking about Daredevil, it wasn't that interesting. You know, Daredevil is a superhero that has, you know, he's powerful but not super powerful. I don't know, that show was a little bit depressing. Anyway, like, just looking back on it, it's just like, he really didn't do much. He was always exhausted, but he's also a superhero. Like, it's cool that he was looked like he was exhausted, but he's also supposed to be a superhero. Like, I want my superheroes to be like, yeah, they could be, you know, get shot and all that stuff, but not feel like they fucking just been wrecked. Like, you're not making this person to be super strong. Like, it would have been better if it was Zorro or something. Fucking literally had the same motif. Or same costume. Coming up on 1 hour. I've been playing Future Fight on mobile. That is an awesome game. I mean, it's a great game for, like, a little, if you want to do something. I don't know, I like it. It's a dungeon crawler game with Marvel. It's like Marvel Heroes. It doesn't have a lot of the licenses. Like, it doesn't have any X-Men or Fantastic Four licenses, but it does have a lot of the Marvel, and it's pretty cool. You build a team, and there's three different elements, so there's kind of like a Pokemon thing where strength, blast, and speed. Strength is good against speed. Speed is good against blast, and blast is good against strength. And then there's a fourth one called Universal, which is a, you know, it doesn't have a good or bad, or doesn't have a vulnerability or strength. And so you make different teams and you run them through dungeons and you get loot, and depending on how good you do, like, somebody dies, you lose a star. If you get 3 stars, you can replay it. And then you can get tickets, which are replay tickets, which you can just auto does the thing, so you don't have to run the thing. But if you get 3 stars, you can also just hit autoplay a plus, which will do the thing for itself. When you do use the tickets, it will you get all the loot, but you won't get experience. And so that's pretty good. There's 2 different types of missions. There's like regular missions, which is it has a little bit of a story. That's where you get mats. And then there's the elite missions, which are a little bit harder, and that's where you can get biometrics. Biometrics are used to upgrade your heroes or create new heroes. So if I have most characters, you just need 10 biometrics to level up. And that way you get you 1 star, and with that 1 star you can level them up to level 40, I think, or 20? And then from there, you can also get, like, stones, too, that gives you leader bonuses. It's actually a really deep game. I might do a video on it sometime. I really like it a lot. It's a good mobile game. I think mobile games should be, like, fun and easy and very engaging. Or not as engaging. Not that engaging, but, like, still, like, kind of, like, feel like you accomplished something at the end. So it does support, I just came way too fast around there. It does support, like, a controller on Android. But you don't need it. The touch controls are perfectly fine. I'm playing on my tablet. It's really fine. It does could burn up your battery real fast. It is actually a really good looking game. All the characters look good. Then they also have skins too. So they recently just did this Secret War 2080 thing. And so you could actually get a female skin of Captain America, which is really cool. Oh, really? It's a really cool game. They introduced Singularity, She-Hulk, and, what do you call it? One other, Wasp? No. I don't know, I forgot her name. But it's cool. At 42 is when we're gonna pit. So it'll be about an hour and not 10 minutes easily. Whoa. I tried the other Marvel games, the fighting games. It's not really good. This game also has, like, there is PvP, so you have a team of three, and you could put them up in, like, automated stuff. So you fight them, you fight other people, and you can get coins from that. And then there's also, like, there's team play. Oh god. Nah, I'm working on it. There's team play, there's all sorts of stuff, but you need to have a character level 40 and then have 4 stars. So it can get a little bit grindy on the top end and a little bit, you know, maybe give us $5 to move that. It's not pay to win. I've dumped $10 into it and I felt pretty good and I probably will put more in it. You're paying, since it is a PvE type of sense, you are paying to progress more than anything else. You buy crystals. Crystals could be used to buy new costumes and upgrades and all that stuff. Most of the currencies are crystals. They do packages every week. It's like, hey, give, you know, 2,000 crystals, you can get a you can get like 50 biometrics of Iron Man and Hawkeye and all that stuff. And then it'll give you some gold and some mastery and all that. So it's a really fleshed out game. Really impressed by it. And they have daily login stuff. And so right now they're doing a autumn event, so you could easily, you could easily get like 4,000 crystals easily, which is like about $30. Crystals are not cheap in that game. Or they're not. They're. I don't know, like, it's, you don't need them to unlock characters. There is, you can use them to unlock characters, but they are as a randomizer. The story consists of, you know, hey, give us, you know, straight up $9 and we'll give you whatever character you want, or you could play the lottery for 700 crystals, or you could, like, give us 2,000 crystals for this. There's gold, but you could also buy gold, but it's, you can get gold pretty fast. If you log in daily, you don't have to do anything, but you log in daily, you get, like, daily stuff. They do events, so sometimes you just log in, you get, like, a new character. It's pretty cool. And it's actually from a Japanese company. I think Japanese mobile developers are the best mobile developers, because they balance free-to-play and monetization microtransactions extremely well. If you feel like you should dump some money, I feel like that's good. Like Castle Crashers, that you really can't do anything without paying money, I feel. Unless you grind for hours and hours and hours. I've paid Puzzle and Dragons, and then some other ones, and I felt pretty good about, I don't know, I didn't put any money, but like, hey, I'm playing a lot. You do a daily login, you get a little bit of stuff, that little bit of stuff that means something. You know, you can get a special, we're gonna cut it close on this next lap. A daily login and a lot of stuff. Having a daily login, it gives you an item, and then having like special events like, hey, log in for the next 7 days and you get this. They do all sorts of cool events in the Marvel Future Fight. You know, log in for the next 7 days straight, and you will get, you know, biometrics for, you know, Wasp or Hulk Buster. It was great. Fallout Shelter was okay. I didn't... I thought there was a lot of bugs in that game, which I was surprised because the game has been out for a while on iOS. Like, not... So there's different layers, and so your characters are 2D, so if there's a character behind another character, so Deathstalkers would come in, and if there's, like, a play, Dweller A is in front of Dweller B, but Dweller A is at 100 health, but Dweller B is going to about to die. There's nothing you can do. Like, you're literally fucked. Dweller B will die. You can't do anything. I'm like, okay, well, that's fucked. And then some other stuff, like just the monotony of a lot of things. Once you start getting more dwellers, it kind of gets really, really hard to navigate because of the lag. Just the shitty frame rate. I'm using a Note 8 tablet. And it's fine for everything else, but it's just like, it just lags so much. So we're gonna pit here. Whoa, that scared the shit out of me. So I'm gonna take a little break. I'm gonna get a pee break and refill up my water. Ooh, okay. We're getting here. We're getting there. Got my water back. Got a monster going. A little thin around the aluminum, though. Let's, resume. Next one would be lap, 64, I guess. Actually, hold on, let me just pop this open. Again, if you're posting comments in the Twitch, I really, the channel, I really appreciate that stuff. Again, I am really focused on the race, but I do appreciate your comments. Do keep on posting. Whew. It's just, this is really taxing on me. Ooh, that's a flat.
That's flat. That's flat. That's flat. Fuck. Ah, crap, I gotta make sure the mic's turned on. Yeah, it is. Cool. Cool. Okay. Whew. That Mazda was flat as hell, so I got a cliff bar instead. Deal with that later. Future Pride, dog. That's where I was last. It's great. There's just enough to log in. You just, like, log in, though. There's alliances and all that stuff. It's kind of deep, but kind of fun for a mobile game. Now, I'm really hoping for Marvel Heroes to come out to a contest, too. Diablo. I have Diablo on Xbox. Really fun game. I like having direct control over a character. And I don't have that on PC. They're not going to add controller support to Diablo on PC. They are adding controller support to Marvel Heroes on PC, though. It should be fun. Perfect. Yeah, I wonder how a multiplayer endurance run would be. That would be pretty interesting. Is that fourth? Yeah, that's fourth. Or no, that was fifth, I think. Shit, I forgot what my pitch strategy was. I did it on 42. I think it was at... The next one was at 20... Last one was at 21?
the 6th? Yes. That might be my last one, I guess. Some water. I like how their first is like a little bit slower than ours. Like the difference between me and fourth place for the best lap is 10 seconds or 9 seconds, and the difference between fourth and their first is it's 10 seconds. It's like, what the fuck? Oh, Jesus. I'm like 20 seconds faster than them, but they're only 10 seconds faster than people behind me. Or 10 seconds slower. Oh my god, come on. That's a weird fucking rewind. It put me back like 2 feet. You know what? I wonder if rewinding doesn't doesn't replenish your fuel. That would be interesting. Of course should be coming up next. Not up here, but today. Oh, we're doing passive. What the fuck? Oh no, it's 48? Did I come to the conclusion of that? No, 30? Wait, no. So it's like 19,000 feet times 2, that's 38. Yeah. Yeah? Yeah, I'm never gonna get a fast 11 when there's all this traffic. I don't know, where are my tires? Pretty good. It's just like how there's a Ferris wheel right there. Get a fast lap here. Push it. Damn it, that's gonna cost me. Oh, it's not a clean lap. So I did get a clean lap, my fast lap is a clean lap. Damn it. I'm not gonna get a clean lap anymore though, because of all this traffic. Like a bump is mixed dirty. It's so bullshit. For some reason, all my fastest laps are usually fucking dirty. It's hilarious. Because you cut corners. Now this is dirty. And the worst part about dirty laps is that you can have a clean lap, but it also be dirty. Because if you're as... if your last lap was just fucking so dirty, it would like carry over. That shit pisses me off. How is my car though? I wanna see how. Yeah, very little damage. When I was doing the Le Mans, the fucking Audi was just trashed. I'm coming up on second place right here, aren't I? God damn it. Yeah, second place. God damn it. God, I need to adjust the skill level. Like, the skill levels in these endurance races, like, seem I should put it a little bit higher. I did highly skilled on Road Atlanta, and I was... there was fifth. I was 700 feet behind, but then I did the next tier down, and I was fucking like 30,000 feet in front. But then I do Bathurst on that, and since they're all the same car style, it's like fucking first was like 2,000 feet ahead, and third, I was in second all the time. Third was like fucking 30 feet behind me. I hate that fucking track. I really do. That's fourth up ahead. Next would be, what is it, 19,000? So, 19,000. Plus 38.
Fuck it.
Yeah. 20 minutes. Jesus Christ. Still lap 51. We have 36. Two would be the mid mark. Oh, so I have like 32. Fuck. Dude, that's... Oh, God. Having these extra cars in the room. Just focus. That's where the Spectre mod is going to come in handy with fucking, like, no collision. Shit, it's fucking crazy. Let's see if we can do a clean lap here. There's no indication on if it's clean or not, which I fucking piss me off. For the 5, then yeah. You know, Gran Turismo does have some crazy cars now. Like, they have like 12,000 cars plus 1,200 cars. Forza like has like a third of that, but a lot of those cars are not premium. They look like PS2 cars. Some of the Wii cars too. They have fucking Volkswagen, the World War II era Volkswagens, like the Germans had. They also had that weird car that had two engines in it. That was... Nobody, like, back in the early days of racing, there really wasn't really any rules when you heard to me. So one person thought, hey, I'm gonna have two engines. One pushing forward, pushing the car forward, and then one sucking it down. So you would have insane fucking grip. So that pissed off a lot of people, because it won, like, a lot. So that's when they introduced a lot. I'm actually really glad this is not the Oval. Really has me worried about the fucking Indy. There's still a couple other, there's a Spa, and then, Catalina, that's what I can do. And then the Bathurst, fucking none of them are rain tracks. I swear to God, I would shoot myself there. Come on, 62 for a pit? That'd have to be earlier than that. there a fuel gauge on this? A fuel? Rate 5.8. Okay, gear number. I think that it might have to do with G's on the left. 2.9. Okay, 7. So none of that changes. That red one's. Oh, fuck you! Seven and 9, so none of that might be where, I guess. And then the 2 indicates maybe G's. We got RPMs, current track time. That might be fuel. Shit. Yeah, that might be fuel. Holy shit, yeah. That's fuel, I'm going. So what's one lap? Fuck it, this cone's going flying. I mean, I'm not worried about like losing because of pitting, but I feel like I just pitted like 10 laps ago. It's 47, it's gonna be 10? Is it gonna be 37 when I pass there? So if that is fuel, that's 1.3 if you're safe. Let's hope that's fuel. It seems like fuel. Oh god. That's always a good sign. Cutting it real close, but I think it is fuel. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to be. Fuck it, we're doing it. One more lap. We're fine. One more lap. Push it, baby. Push it. Because I got less fuel in the tank. I can go faster, less weight. Should be able to grimmel. It's totally fuel. Cool, wow. I like how fucking lap 57... Lap 56 I figure out... Oh, there's a fuel gauge on the fucking wheel that tells me how much fuel I have left. It's probably, what, liters? Oh god, no rewind, fuck you. Dude, I might have enough for another lap. To the left, there's something blinking, but it's the fucking, like, reflection of something. It's, like, flashing right next to the first. Like, yes, you are first! So, I do it at 42. Like, 12 up. I guess every 12 laps I've been going? Yeah, it is fuel. Jesus. So what does that mean? That I have 20 divided by... So I should end at 18.7? Got it. I don't like how the fucking hand takes up my whole field of view. Oh god, I'm starting to lose it now. Coming around that fucking corner, it's 23 more laps I gotta do. About a third left. Having to deal with this fucking oh god damn it. I'm going in for a pit right now then. That fuck! Yeah, everything's fucked now. God damn it. I hit him in the front and nothing happens in the front. So fucking stupid. This is when, like, the rewind starts working, but then you're starting to get fatigue. I'm trying to figure out what... The rear... Why would the rear brake, a rear suspension fucking brake when I hit him in the front? So fucking stupid. Ugh. Oh, my lights are out. That's... I wonder when they went out. I never even noticed that. Dude, his lights are out too. That's a lot of people's... Oh, no, they're on. No, they're out. That fucking sucks, because if their lights go out, my lights go out, I can't see. But when theirs lights out, they still fucking see, because there's things that cause that. His lights are on. Jesus Christ, the difference between second and third is fucking crazy.
Makes me wonder why,
Bathass is the only, like, one of the... Actually, never looked at anything. Bathass is the only, like, everybody's the same car, while everything else I've had was, like, different car, classes. Fucking hell, 22 more laps. Or no, actually 21. It's fucking getting in. It's taking a toll on me. That means I'm like, what, 40 minutes away? Jesus Christ. No. No, long. Whoa! That didn't scare the shit out of me. I wish it would like tell me fastest dirty lap or fastest clean lap when I pass this thing, because this is clearly going to be a faster lap than my clean lap, and I want to know how much faster is it compared to my fastest dirty lap. To do with this fucking traffic really pisses me off in turn trying to make it like it, there's no reason to get like clean laps. No, I mean there's no, it's so fucking hard to get clean laps. You do that in the first like probably 30 or 10 laps, then you start running into the lower class cars. It would be cool if they added an expansion pack for this, like maybe like some other cars like they did, no, not just cars, but like events at the, because for Forza Horizon they had the Storm Island expansion pack, which added new cars and some new tracks. It would be cool if that was here, if, like they added like, we added new endurance runs or new tracks and all that stuff. That would be cool. Like now we have a 24 Le Mans, 24 Nürburgring. Time ones are feel like a little bit better than laps. Like 24 hours in Indianapolis. Oh, oh God, thank God. And then when they hit me too, that's a fucking dirty lap. That pisses me off the most. The rival system is so fucking cool, so robust, great. Like, playing... I played Drive Club. So, I played Forza Horizon 2, and then Drive Club. And, like, Forza Drive Club, or Drive Club was supposed to come out before Forza Horizon 2. It's supposed to come out alongside the Monster PS4. It was delayed. And that stuff they do is pretty interesting, but if you play, like, I mean, Need for Speed has that shit. Oh, God, come on, apps. We don't play Camera. Forza has it, Forza Horizon has it, Forza Motorsports has it. It's like, it's nothing interesting, and I feel like that's the only part of that game that's anyone interested, anybody else. Like, if you have a PS4, yeah, Drive Club is great for that stuff, but, like, the grand pantheon of racing games, it's not that great. Like, it is cool to, like, see ghosts and all that stuff, but, like, it's not nothing new, though. It's nothing new. Like, Forza 5 did it, like, before you guys. With the rivals and all that stuff. Maybe they were in Forza 4. I think after this I'm gonna install Gran Turismo 5 and hope I have a save on that so I can look at the endurance races on that. And then Forza 4 too. See if there's any endurance races. That should be pretty fun. Just a retrospective like where the games are, where have they gone, how they look visually, like a lot of people are like, wow, these curves are like, they look pretty, but like, if you look back, go back to these other games, it just looks so bad, and like, it's just so grimy. I mean, it's just like lower texture, it's lower resolution, that's the only difference between current gen right now and last gen. Like, we have a higher level of fidelity, but the games are still exactly the fucking same. And that's a little bit disturbing for this new console, because these new consoles do have new architecture that they can use to have, you know, these games can be a little bit more robust. When you have games like, Shadows of Mordor, that is completely different on this whole past gen. Like, that whole Nemesis, shit is not in the previous gen. Like, Assassin's Creed Unity, like, was like the first. Did it come out to last year? No, yeah, it did. Like, one of the Assassin's Creeds that first came out was the only one that came out. It came out on PS4 and Xbox One and PC, and that was supposed to be, like, their next, you know, big thing. It was just, like, it was the same game. Now it has co-op, and it has, you know, more people. It's visually more, but overall, it's still the fucking same game. You know, this generation has been, like, the tail end of last generation and the first of this generation, just nothing but remasters. It's a little bit disturbing. You know, it's Sony that's like the harbinger of a lot of this stuff. Like, God of War 3 remastered, like, fucking a year later they remastered Last of Us. Like, are you fucking kidding me? Please tell me this is not the fucking, like, herald of what the fuck is coming on with this game. And of this console generation. And of course it was the herald. Like, it's fucking retarded now. Like, we got Uncharted coming out, we have God of War that's out, we have, you know, Devil May Cry 4, and now they're remastering a couple other things, remastered, Darksiders. Grand Theft Auto is not a remastered, it's just the game. It's just the port, it's the version of, it's, like, Last of Us is just 60 FPS, 1080p, you know, that. It really didn't do much there. And a lot of these other ones, you know, same with God of War, is just 1080p 30, or 1080p 60. Like, Grand Theft Auto on PS4 looks gorgeous, and they're also officially adding new stuff that will only be on these new consoles and PC. Like, it's aggravating. Like, yes, I know there's a lot of people that didn't play that stuff, but, like, I didn't buy a $400 piece of hardware to play games that were out last year. That's what I did last generation. You know? I had a PS3, I played all these games. You know, The Last of Us was really generic. It really felt like just a straight up third-person shooter. It didn't do anything interesting. I thought the story was very lackluster. Like, it felt like so hamstrung. First fucking half of... It actually makes me angry about that game. It really does. First half of that game, your character, Joel, is like, I don't like this girl. I am doing this for the money. And he's doing it for his own personal gain and all stuff. And then when he talks to his brother, boom, now they're BFFs. And we have no process... we have no sense of time in that game. And so we see fall and all that stuff. So over the course of, like, maybe 9 months, we get a like, person that hates them and then loves them. And then at the very end, spoilers, you take her and selfishly take her. Like, what? No, you should have just like, no. It was just really made no sense. And there was one part, kind of like the third or the second act, when it gets really fucking rapey. And like, what the fuck? That's went really dark. And I'm not a fan of zombie games. I think they're the worst type of games. Usually they don't have any sort of content. Like, there's no very little story. The story is too much. Zombie shows are different. Zombie video games are really about killing zombies, not like any character development. And so they're the easiest games to make because you don't have to program any fucking like AI or any story. Like, Dying Light was a really fun game, but like a really shitty game. Like, had really no story or anything. Okay, getting close to my lap soon. About 2 hours though, Jesus Christ. Like, one thing I would have liked if they announced like a Gran Turismo 6 update or something, or Gran Turismo 7 Prologue. But no, they didn't. Like, I don't know what Sony's doing. They're not making games, is what I tell you. Like, they're making parts. Uncharted 4, it's gonna look good, but like, it's gonna be more of the same stuff. Like, it's, and I really didn't like 3. I really liked 2, but I didn't really like 3 because it was just like, this is the fucking same game as 2. Like, they didn't iterate anything on the game. That's what I liked about, what the fuck? I liked about Tomb Raider, because it was like, it was pretty much Uncharted, but it was different. It was different enough, like, you could play this stealthily, you could, you know, do different things, with a little bit of a crafting system, with a little bit of an RPG system to it. And it felt really good game. And I'm gonna like what they do from there with Rise of the Tomb Raider. With the difference between Uncharted 2, 3, 4 is, like, really just visuals. Like, and then tighten up, like, the story a little bit. But other than that, it's the same game. You know, you're still shooting the same way. You're still... There's nothing more than that. You know, they gutted out the multiplayer. There's no real co-op in the game. So it's a straightforward third-person shooter. That will look gorgeous. Look gorgeous. But there's nothing to it. You know, some people say, like, oh, you gotta play The Last of Us multiplayer. I'm like, I don't want to do that. That looks really tedious, and it seems really niche, so there's probably not a lot of people playing. When there's not a lot of people playing, that means you're probably gonna get really shitty connections. Jesus Christ, third place is 70 fucking thousand feet back. Fourth place is 80,000. Fucking second place is 50,000. Jesus Christ, what is wrong with this AI? I don't want to bump it up because I don't want to, like, too scared that, like, it's... Maybe in the Indian one I'll bump it up and see what happens. Like, of course there's the Master Chief Collection, that's okay. You know, but that game is being made, is pretty much being made to, like, supplement Halo. Uncharted 8 is the same thing, but, like, God of War 3, not really doing anything. You know, Devil May Cry, same with that. A couple other games.
What?
And, oh, yeah, Infamous. That was a boring game. Their first-party lineup from Sony is just not doing it. Not Infamous Second Son. Look, again, look gorgeous! Fucking boring as shit! Like, they focused more on the story, and it was a shitty open world. The first game actually got a flat. Wait, two more laps I can do? This season, this holiday season should be pretty good. You got Fallout, you know, Uncharted should be pretty fun for people that have never played it, but, like, I don't know, if you play those games, there's really no reason to replay them. I mean, they're gonna be 1080 or 60, but, like, I wrap those games up, like, I'm done with those games, like, I really don't play games, come back, and, oh, wow, look how pretty this game is. You know, I play console games for... because that's where I feel like it's fun, you know, instead of sitting in front of my computer, just play the game. And, you know, you're going to get, like, a little bit less fidelity than on a PC, but it's going to be a little bit more relaxing. Playing The Witcher, I couldn't play The Witcher 3 in front of my TV or monitor, but it's just like, Jesus, doing, like, 80 hours in front of a fucking monitor? Jesus Christ. No, but, like, on a couch, I can, you know, change vision. Oh my god, 10 more laps. So this will be the last pit. One time I came through a pit, and yeah, like I went through it. Like it didn't pit me. Wow, 0.9 liters. Woo.
Ugh. 8 more laps. Whew. It's been like 10 more minutes. I think my tires are wearing out. I should probably check my tires. It's too late now, actually. I think I was running out of fuel faster than I was wearing down my tires. I remember I was getting like a 40 previous one. This time it's like, I think I'm running out of fuel faster. I wonder how electric cars are. Those fucking Prius cars and fucking Gran Turismo. Those fucking shit was crazy. Oh no, fuck you! Get out of my way. Whoa! Oh my god! This is not good. Oh god, this is not good. I'm gonna limp into the... Oh god, thank god I'm fucking like 3 laps in front. God damn it. What's fucked? What isn't fucked? Steering is 100, transmission is 100, driveline is 100. So I'm gonna be fucking limping across the fucking Daytona. Probably do. Oh god. Somehow faster than this fucking Audi. Get out of the fucking way, you stupid piece of shit. Fucking hit me. He fucking hit me and then somebody else rammed into him. Fucked up my drive, my steering perfectly so I don't have to fucking like turn.
Oh my god. I'm actually not turning. I am not turning the wheel. There it is. This is fucking hilarious. What about right there, yeah. God, that doesn't sound good. Yeah, it was off kilter. Yeah, we're golden. Whoa, that doesn't skip. Fuck you! That fucker fucking hit me, and so he probably lost a lot of shit too. I forgot that, like, maybe they can also get into car accidents and have to pay everything. I know, I still think that they're bringing the best one. That was like an hour from the speed limits. That fucking like 84. This has been turned into the longest endurance race I've done. I've done, well, the stream, I've done 4 hours. That was Roadland on Nürburgring, and then part of Mount Ashland. And you can check that out on my YouTube, I got that linked. I got that in my channel. Okay. And then, in Le Mans was about a little over 2 hours, like exactly like almost 2 hours. Very impressed by that. This is fucking turning into an hour, like 2 hours and 30 minutes maybe. Really fucking glad that pitting actually fixes shit. Cause you can't do that in real life. You can't fix fucking drivetrain fucking pit. That's where, like, maybe I want to bump it up might not be better. Like, it's random shit can happen. That's the thing. Random shit can happen. I cannot get the rewind. So I'm like limping for one thing, and then they start passing me. I'm like, oh fuck. So having that huge buffer is really nice. You know, it is. It's really not. The problem I'm running into right now is that, like, there's so much traffic on here, I can't hit these that fast. Now I have rewind. My driving line is gone. Well, because I'm going like 30 miles an hour. But again, I'll archive this up on YouTube. I'll put the starting thing on the starting time, and then the ending time, and then that's pretty much it. The Le Mans ones I did post a or put a time when I lost the actual lights. I guess I lost the lights. I could have kept on going back, but I still thought, like, maybe I could get them repaired in the pit, but it was like, past the pit, like, fuck this, I just keep on going, I can do this. And then it got real fucking bad. Real bad. But I'm actually really impressed that I actually made it. Like, not having lights in a night map is fucking crazy. Like, you can't see anything. You couldn't see anything. That was right. I did 35 lap. That's crazy. Time is. think I'll do the Indy next. And I'll set probably about 8 o'clock tonight. I'll probably do that. Holy shit, dude. I'm a fucking second ahead. Let's see if I can get this as a clean lap. I'm probably clean, so let's keep it clean. Let's go with the assumption that I am clean. Damn it, I'm not clean anymore. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Damn it, it was a dirty lap. It was a dirty lap. Fuck. Where the fuck were you when I got in a fucking huge pile of rewind? That's what I'm okay with having rewind on. Or... Where's the 5, I think they did in the bets, where you, every time you rebound, 1% of your money was deducted from your winnings, and that was cool. Because sometimes you would need it, like some of the random shit you would encounter in that game. And Forza is just way too much, because it's bright, dark cars. But I'm pretty sure the next 20 laps are fucking bad. Still, like, fucking 3 laps in front of them. Second place. Jesus Christ. Two more laps. That looked like I was gonna fucking clip that thing. Fuck, I break. I should've just plowed right through it. It would be really nice if the you hit like the pause menu and tell me which lap everybody's on. That'd be really nice. See if we can get this a clean lap. Not clean anymore. We'll keep it clean. We'll keep it clean. Not clean. Definitely not clean anymore. Definitely not clean. Back and cheeky bastard that fucking hit me. lane. Into the straight lane. Oh, God. That was really long. A little scary. Oh, God. Oh, shit. So I made $1 million off that. Holy fucking shit. Holy shit. 300,000 for earnings. 300,000 for VIP. 120,000 for assist. 105,000 for difficulty, 180,000 for the mod, superior payout. Holy shit. I gained 9 levels from that. Oh, Jesus. Fucking butt! Doesn't matter. There's no. It's just 100% random. Chevy Bel Air. You get so much fucking cash now. It's crazy. Give me the Maserati. It's gonna give me the Maserati because I think I already have that. Oh, I don't. Holy shit, and I got $130,000 for fucking leveling up affinity with Pugat. Oh god, is it Pugat. Pugatti. No. Peugeot. Fuck. Whew. Race results here. 2 hours. 2 hours. 20 minutes. In 1 second. Fuck. Wow. That's actually leaderboards here. Ooh, top, almost in the top 300 for speed. But, yeah. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys had fun watching me fucking go around in a circle for 2.5 hours. I like doing these. I'll see you... Wow, it's already 5 o'clock. Jesus fucking Christ. I'll set up a schedule for later on. If not, I'll post it a little bit later. I'll definitely come back tomorrow. I don't know if it will be a new one from earlier today. But as always, thanks for watching, and you guys have a wonderful day.